Tesla continued to reduce the affordability of its cars this year, with another increase in prices for the basic version of all models in the United States. Not only that, but the estimated delivery time for certain versions has also increased. On the other side, the automaker punishes careless FSD beta testers by canceling the program, and Elon Musk warns people that they need to pay attention, and Tesla is watching. Tesla Model 3 is the fastest-selling EV of all time, with 24 units sold every hour. In addition, after switching to lithium iron phosphate batteries for Model 3 and Model Y electric vehicles in the Chinese market, Tesla plans to expand the use of these batteries to the global market, which may include the production of LFP batteries in the United States. A recent drone flyover of Tesla's China factory shows that the site is still an activity center, which may be just right considering that the factory may soon export Model Y to the UK. Also in China, the company has reached the important milestone of installing 1,000 supercharging stations, which accounts for almost one-third of the network. Hey everyone, and welcome back to Technopool, where we bring you the newest and best updates about Tesla, Elon Musk, and of course the EV industry. For daily videos, please consider subscribing to our channel and smash the bell button to receive all notifications. Tesla is increasing the price of the basic versions of Model 3 and Model Y. This is only the second time this month. The delivery schedule was postponed again for a few months. Starting with the Tesla Model 3, the standard range plus version is now $2,000, or almost 5% more expensive, starting at $43,990. To make matters worse, the potential customer should be prepared to wait for their standard range plus for almost a year until September 2022, at least if he will not pay more for the larger optional wheels to get the car in June 2022. Let's note that between now and December 2020, Tesla has increased the price by $7,500 from $36,490 to $43,990. Considering the increased value and inflation, the real increase is not as high, but it's clear that Tesla cars are now less affordable and far beyond the $35,000 target that once was promised and only shortly available. The Tesla Model Y Long Range AWD also is now $2,000, or 3.6% more expensive at $56,990. Its estimated delivery time increased by a month to May or August, depending on the wheel option. Compared to December 2020, it's $8,500, or 17.5% more expensive. Tesla has increased by $5,000 the price of Model S Long Range AWD and Model X Long Range AWD, respectively, to $94,990 by 5.6% and to $104,990 by 5%. We guess that the company has no choice but to increase the prices of products that are in high demand, because the queue to get some of the most popular versions may soon reach a full year. As long as things remain like this, we will not be able to see cheaper Tesla cars, especially because the company is expected to achieve the highest car profit margins in the world. Tesla continues to make it very clear that the Autopilot and fully Autopilot beta systems require the driver's attention and be prepared to take control immediately upon notification. Its new safety score attempts to exclude people who are not driving in a way that helps test plans or who are making unsafe driving decisions. In addition to those measures, Tesla is kicking beta testers out of the program for improper usage of the technology. Tesla owners may have brought some people to see this technology. We are not sure what happened, but it seems that other Tesla owners have also been removed from the test plan. According to Teslarati, Tesla has sent emails to some FSD beta testers, letting them know that their driving activity has been flagged. More specifically, these owners were simply warned that they were using the technology incorrectly or irresponsibly. It seems that if you abuse FSD beta, you will receive a warning. If the problem persists, Tesla will remove you from the beta part of the program. However, these people have already paid for the technology, and once it is released to the public, it will almost certainly still be eligible for the update. If not, Tesla will have to refund them. Teslarati said that Tesla pays special attention to drivers who look at their phones or do not pay attention to the road. Although there may be some Tesla owners who are pushing the limits of FSD beta in other ways, inattention seems to be Tesla's biggest concern, which makes perfect sense. Elon Musk recently tweeted that FSD beta testers must remain vigilant no matter how capable they believe the technology is becoming. He also made it clear that they'll be booted if they aren't super careful. The Tesla Model 3 is the fastest-selling electric car in history, with more than 24 sales per hour, based on the average annual sales of the car. Model 3 defeated some fierce competition and became the fastest-selling electric car in the world, including Model Y, which has surpassed Model 3 and became Tesla's best-selling car. A new study by LeaseLoco has determined which cars can claim to be the fastest and best-selling cars on the planet. Although electric vehicles are relatively new to the automotive industry on a mass-market scale, they are becoming more and more mainstream every day. There is no doubt that Tesla is the most popular electric car brand on the planet, and although the automaker has not yet reached the scalability or output of the world's largest car company, it is proceeding smoothly. If the data obtained by LeaseLoco can show Tesla's prospects, then the auto industry can look forward to the emergence of new dominant forces in the automotive field. It will not be Ford, it will not be Volkswagen, it will not be General Motors, it will be Tesla. Data shows that Tesla sells about 24.5 Model 3s per hour. On average, Tesla sells 215,000 Model 3s each year, and the number of models manufactured is increasing slowly, but surely almost every month. There's no doubt that this number will increase by the end of 2021 because Tesla is expected to sell nearly 900,000 cars in 2021, about half of which are Model 3. Model 3 is not the only model Tesla made on the list. Although Model Y has a life cycle of only 18 months as a Tesla car, it ranks third with an average annual sales of 100,000 vehicles, which is equivalent to 11.4 vehicles sold per hour. This is impressive for a relatively new car and Tesla's first attempt at a crossover. One of the most interesting announcements made by Tesla yesterday on its third quarter 2021 earnings conference call was a strategy to ship all of its standard range vehicles to cheaper LFP or lithium iron phosphate battery chemistries. For standard range vehicles, we are shifting to lithium iron phosphate battery chemistry globally, Tesla said in its Q3 shareholders deck. This is the strategy that Tesla has adopted in the Chinese market since the Model 3 was produced in Shanghai in early 2020. However, now Tesla plans to transfer Model 3 standard range and Model Y standard range vehicles to LFP packs, which is definitely more useful than standard nickel-cobalt aluminum packages. Tesla actually switched to using the LFP package in some standard range Model 3 and provided customers with the opportunity to use the package so that they can receive the goods faster. In late August, Tesla sent a message to some Model 3 subscribers via email, saying that the battery pack could be replaced with a good supply LFP battery pack. Tesla emailed those who had the vehicle on order in August, saying, "We are contacting you about your Model 3 Standard Range Plus, currently estimated for delivery near the end of the year. We'd like to offer you the opportunity to receive your car even sooner. Due to limited supply and strong customer demand, we are introducing the Model 3 Standard Range Plus battery pack, which we already released in Europe and Asia, to North America. This battery has a range of 253 miles. This strategy may be related to Tesla's demand, which has exceeded its production speed. LFP batteries are cheaper than NCA batteries and have a longer service life. The disadvantage of switching to this package is the lower energy density, which means less power and range. LFP batteries are also more susceptible to weather, which may result in lower rated ranges and large differences in power output." CEO Elon Musk said that Tesla's intention with the LFP pack is that the product experience is roughly equivalent between nickel and iron. Musk added that he'd personally opt for iron pack as it wants to be charged to 100%, whereas nickel prefers till to 90%. Musk also made comments regarding the LFP packs during the Q2 2021 earnings call. "I think probably there is a long-term shift more in the direction of iron-based lithium-ion cells rather than nickel. I think probably we'll see a shift. My guess is probably to 2/3 iron, 1/3 nickel, or something on that order. And this is actually good because there's plenty of iron in the world. There's an insane amount of iron. But nickel, there's much less nickel, and there's way less cobalt. So many automakers turn to electrification, leading to a shortage of some battery materials, which may also be Tesla's strategy to switch to LFP batteries. The shortened delivery time can be solved by switching to other materials, but Tesla also plans to address the shortage by expanding its manufacturing footprint at two new production facilities in Berlin and Austin, Texas." In China, Giga Shanghai does not seem content to rest on its laurels after a blockbuster September. Since October 2018, UAV operator Wuhua has been paying attention to the development of the site. A recent visit showed that the production of Model 3 and Model Y in Shanghai's superfactory is still running at full speed. The video shot in the warehouse of the factory shows that a large number of all-electric cars and crossovers are also being transported from the Shanghai superfactory. The Shanghai Gigafactory has developed into one of Tesla's largest assets, and the plant described it as a major automobile export center in its second quarter 2021 update letter. So far, about half of the Shanghai supercar's quarter time is used to produce export cars, and the other half is used to cater to the local Chinese market. The Shanghai Gigafactory has exported its vehicles to foreign regions such as Europe and Asia. The Giga Shanghai effectively provides some breathing space for Tesla's Fremont factory as it increases production of the new Model S and Model X. Elon Musk seemed to acknowledge the contribution of the Shanghai Gigafactory to Tesla's overall operations, and at the time he personally praised the plant in the 2021 annual general meeting of shareholders. "I want to lend a helping hand to the Tesla China team, so it has the best quality, lowest cost, and low drama, so it's great," Musk said. Shanghai Gigafactory's role as Tesla's main export center may have just begun. Just recently, Tesla officially opened Model Y orders in the UK. Although the long-range variant of the all-electric crossover is priced as high as £5,490, $75,500, the expected delivery date of the vehicle is early 2022. The estimated time frame indicates that Model Y, or at least its first delivery, may come from the Shanghai Superfactory. Also in China, Tesla has reached an important milestone in the installation of 1,000 superchargers in mainland China, including 100 in Shanghai, 1,000 stalls, and 100 in Hainan province. The company celebrated the 1,000 mark with a special display. The total number of single supercharging stations exceeds 7,600, which means that there is an average of 7.6 stalls per station, compared with the total number of more than 3,250 sites and more than 29,250 stalls installed globally by the end of the third quarter of 2021. China accounts for nearly one-third of the network. Its share has grown rapidly, second only to North America. "We guess that in the near future, we may see that China will have more superchargers than the United States." According to data from supercharge.info, 1,168 charging stations have been installed in the United States. CNEV Post reported that in addition to supercharging stations, Tesla has installed more than 700 destination charging points alternating current in China, with approximately 1,750 individual stalls. For reference, NIO has nearly 400 sites, about 2,400 stalls, and more than 550 battery replacement sites. Another Chinese startup company, XiaoPeng, has also expanded its network, as of May, with more than 1,000 charging stations. The superchargers of the Tesla V3 version can provide up to 250 kilowatts of power, which is one of the highest levels on the market. However, it is not the peak power, but the relatively wide availability of charging locations, integration with navigation and full-speed warm-up function, simple plug-and-charge approach, and high reliability that make the network very successful. So that's all for today. We hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to leave your comment in the section below. And please don't forget to like and subscribe, and be sure to turn on the notification bell so you don't miss out on any of our new videos. There are many more future-focused tech videos coming soon, so until then, stay tuned, and we'll see you in the next video.